I'm going to talk about the non-Ukrainian alignment politics to start. So basically, I want to talk about that this topographic pattern induced alignment politics to start is very versatile, and so that we can expect more complicated, alignment of more complicated liquid crystals or alignment in other ways. So first I will let me introduce some contributors. So the elastic energy calculation is done by Neil Ashby and Joe Baglana, and the simulation Giuseppe Lombard at the University of Calabria, and the material thiolin polymer applied material is provided by Biopower and Christopher Homa, and the Gold Clark is the advisor. So I will briefly introduce about background of liquid crystal alignment, and then non-infinite alignment, then our result about non-infinite alignment of liquid crystals. So the motivation is, so this shows the surreal and texture of the nomadic liquid crystals, shows very beautiful, but for most device applications we need some uniform optical, electrical, elastic characteristics, so we want to control the alignment of liquid crystals. And this shows how liquid crystal interacts with the surface. So for nomadic case, the liquid crystal can be either planar on the surface or homeotropic, depending on the interaction between surface and the liquid crystal molecule. And for this first case, this is planar and this is homeotropic. So, the goal of the alignment of liquid crystal is actually we want capability to align various liquid crystals in our desired way. So, Behrmann studied the alignment of the mechanism of alignment of liquid crystal by topographic structure. So he, for this sinusoidal structure of the linear grooves with the amplitude A and the wave vector Q, the elastic energy for the this case is expressed as this compared to the zero elastic energy event for this case. So by introducing topography on the surface, we can manipulate liquid crystal directors. And so using that scheme, so people used various structures to manipulate alignment of liquid crystal. So for example, this square post structure produces bistable alignment for in-plane and for tilted two states are possible in this case. And for this case, this is square rare structure, and this shows in-plane bistable alignment of this diagonal, for the wrong diagonal direction. is equally possible to the lightning. And also using the AFM rubbing, people also achieve a tri-stable alignment for high view to improve the viewing angle performance. So this is a very simple cartoon of the Nanning print. So basically you prepare mold and then put some polymerizable material and then press the material and the substrate and mold together and then polymerize. So our case, this is a very simple and mass producible method. So we use the e-beam lithography to prepare e-beam lithography and then plasma etching to prepare molds and then use the thiol in polymerization to polymerize the soft material. So we first studied the interaction between liquid crystal and the thiolene material. So to calculate the polar anchoring energy. So first we prepared about 10 micron scale linear line pattern and then overlapped the two patterns so that the lines are parallel. So we made uniform alignment and then studied the measure of the retardation versus the voltage. Then from this measurement, we found the saturation voltage and then find the anchoring energy. So the anchoring energy is about 0.1 L per square centimeter, which is about close to the strong anchoring energy region. And this shows the versatility of the alignment of nomadic liquid crystal with various patterns. So this is array of square wells or square grid patterns. So this shows this region is the overall alignment in the series along the diagonal directions. And this is a linear line pattern area. So as you can see that from here to here, the contrast reverse. And this cell is a 5 CV cell with one surface with a pattern surface for one window and with a random planar surface for the other window. So to achieve random planar surface, we used ethylene glycol liquid so to minimize the influence of the other surface to the alignment of the liquid crystal. And then so because we see that bistable alignment of the square grid well is interesting, I want to just share the details. So the director can be in either direction, equally possible. So that this is, and we observe also the domain boundaries here. So this supports that this is bistable, in-plane bistable alignment. And this is the optical transmission simulation with the boundary condition fixed to the along the edges, so which matches with this and this texture very well. And we just a little bit modified the square grid pattern, so using basically square array of rhombus. So this rhombus has a longer axis in this direction, and this area has a longer axis in this direction. So we expect that liquid crystal reactor will, this is more stable if directly in this direction and this is this direction. So we expect that the main boundary is here. Actually, it should be around here. So I think this, the boundary influences that alignment. And then, so we further reduce the size and increase the depth of the square wells. So this is a 200 nanometer checkerboard pattern and the 400 nanometer checkerboard pattern made by nanoimprint. And as you can see from the liquid crystal texture through the polarized optical microscope, there is a transition, gradual transition from the hard planar to homeotropic. So as you can see here, 400 nanometer case, it doesn't, the brightness doesn't change whether you locate the sample. So that means this is essentially homeotropic alignment. And then this shows average tilted along the diagonal direction. So we look into a little more details. So first, we observe that planar bistable alignment for the shallow and large wells. So we first calculate the elastic energy if we assume what will be the elastic energy if we assume it is the planar case. So with this director configuration, and so we can calculate the elastic energy of this director field, and then we also, there should be some effect at the four line edges, So by adding this defect energy, so we can calculate the energy, elastic energy and the defect energy. So this is the graph. So actually this is the energy density, so energy per unit area. And this is the surface anchoring energy we measured. So as you can see, the elastic energy part increases, overcomes the surface and planar anchoring. So at around 300 nanometer, the vertical alignment, homeotropic alignment is more favorable. So this is finite elementary simulation of the cases. So this is the geometry of the simulation. So this box shows the simulation area. So this is actually cross section of the square wells, in the middle of the square wells. So as you can see, this 200 nanometer well case, this is where this is the bulk in this region. So right, and the top surface is treated with the OTES sand so that it is homeotropic. So for 200 nanometer, where most regions are dark, which means the tilt angle is near tilt angle 90 degrees. So, except the very near the bottom of the well and the shoulder of the well, it's mostly dark, or the tilt angle is 90 degrees. Compared to the 600 nanometer wells, which shows that pretty much bright areas, large bright areas. So, and then we also put the semantic A liquid crystal ACV. So this is also the same case. The one surface is homeotropic and the other is pattern. So this shows that also at 200 nanometer, it's completely dark. So it's perfect for metroscopy. And so in summary, I have shown that topographic pattern align liquid crystals uniformly by array of linear world and in plane by stable by world with four-fold symmetry and homotropic by narrow and high worlds. So we can treat the we can manipulate liquid crystal organization with various combination of world structures. So now in-plane alignment will enable us to manipulate anisotropic subcooling matter by controlling a geometry and scale of topographic patterns at low cost. Thank you.
Thanks,
Questions?
Yeah, back there.